let's declare computer name and equals to open and close quotations. Computer name is going to be the computer that we want to clean up. For this example, inside of double quotations, I'm going to do PC02 and I'm going to declare another variable, and the variable is going to be profile path. Again, it doesn't have to be these particular variables. Let's do an open and close quotation, and you could do whatever you want. You say computer or path. It's up to you. This is how I'm building it. Within the open and close quotations, we're actually going to give it C:\users, because that is the path where all the profiles are located. Declare another variable, and we're going to call it profiles, right? Exclude equals, and we're going to do at counts that I do not want to delete would be Bernardo.Orocho, because that is my admin account that I log into my environment. I'm going to hit comma. We're going to do another open and close quotation, and inside there we're going to do BTNHD. I'm going to do another comma. BTNHD for this scenario would be the account that I'm telling everyone in the office to log into, because it's already cashed in. There's a couple of other accounts that we do not want to delete, so we're going to do another open and close quotation, and that's definitely the default. We do not want to delete that one. And we're going to hit another comma, and we're going to do open and close quotation, and we do not want to delete the public. So there's certain profiles that you do not want to delete. So let's declare a variable, and this variable, we're going to call it all profiles, and the WMI commandlet that I am going to use would be get WMI object. You could auto tab that to auto complete it. Gotta love that auto complete. And the parameter that we're going to do is win32_user-profile. And we're gonna do move over a little bit. We're gonna do a parameter of computer name. And the computer name, the parameter has to have something. So what do you think we're gonna be using? Yes, the variable that we declared in line one, which would be $computer name. With this command, it's going to be a long one, so we're going to use a pipe, which should be that line. That's why I pipe. And we are going to do a where object. So where object autocomplete, and we're going to do a wiggly, and inside the wiggly bracket, we're going to do $_period, and we're actually going to do a special equals to $false. And for line eight, let's declare for each. So we declare for each, and within for each, let's open and close a parentheses. And within open and close parentheses, let's declare variable as a placeholder. So the placeholder is going to be profile, and we're going to do in. So the profile, variable profile, is going to be a placeholder for all profiles. So everything inside all profiles is going to jump into profiles. We are going to do open wiggly brackets. Now from here, let's declare a variable of username. We need to actually call out profiles, and we're going to do a period to use, and one of them is called local, and we're going to do open and close parentheses, and inside the open and close parentheses, we're going to do single quotes. Inside the single quotes, we're going to do the backslash. And an option for the split is open and close brackets. Inside here, we're going to do a -1. Okay. If profiles to exclude, we're going to do a parameter of not contains. Gotta use those autocompletes, man. Not contains $username. So let's close this if, and we're going to do another wiggly. And we're going to hit tab. I'm going to do a right host, auto tab that, and we're going to do double quotes, grabbing stuff. We haven't been removing anything. Now we are going to tell the PowerShell script to remove stuff. So we are going to be using the remove item, if I spell it right, remove item command. And we're going to use the parameter of path, and give it the path. So we're actually gonna do open and close quotations. And within open and close quotations, we're going to actually call out our profile. Now that we have our path, there's other parameters that you could use within remove item. So we're actually gonna do a force. We're gonna hit enter, And within the enter, we're going to close the wiggly brackets. This wiggly bracket is closing the if. Now, because we have an if, we need an else. So I'm going to hit enter here. I'm going to do a tab and else. You know, if we can't remove the profile, what that means, we're excluding it. We're bypassing it or skipping it. And we're going to just do a right host, because the right host, do autocomplete, open and close. Right host is going to say, hey, we're excluding this one. And now we need to close the for each. Boom. So everything is closed up. And if you want, let me zoom out because it looks a little better that way. I'm going to do a control A to select everything. And let's clean downstairs a bit and let's just run it. That's it. Run it. Let me zoom in real quick. That looks nice. That's pretty. Excluding, I spelled profile wrong, which is okay.